joined this time by Peachczar of Pokemon fame.
Hello. Nice to greet everybody.
Oh yeah. No, this is a good time. Have you spent any time in the AI dungeon?
Briefly. I got it on mobile a while back and I played it, but it's been a hot second.
You'll be happy to know that for all of the things that you look for, it hasn't changed. It's gotten...
Gotcha.
So there's one major change that's happened, and it's gotten more stable, but all that means is that it goes on longer and doesn't really stop, which can be great, but it also just means that it just doesn't stop. Like, it doesn't crash.
Like a train?
Yeah, no, it... Think of it like a train, but instead of crashing, it just continues and never actually reaches a destination. So it's stable, but they didn't, like... It's not any smarter, I guess? Which is, again, both good and bad.
Yeah. Kind of like a AI dungeon bullet train from hell.
Exactly. All right, let's go ahead and get started here. Let's do a new game. And where would you like to begin? Got a couple options.
Clearly, let's see. I think Cyberpunk's a good option.
Cyberpunk it is. Mm-hmm. Number 5. Who do we want to be? We could be a cyberpunk. We could be a number of things. I mean, this part doesn't even matter because chances are like 10 minutes in, we're going to be somebody completely different.
True, true. Let's start with the punk.
Start with the punk. Number 2. Ooh, okay. For a name. Let's split this up. We got a surname and we got a first name. What would our surname be?
Oh, it's gotta be something... It's gotta be something dumb but cool.
Gotta be, like, grimy but also cybernetic.
Yeah, and super cheesy. Oh man.
Max bitrate.
That's a great one, honestly.
Want to go for max bitrate?
Yeah, let's go.
All right. Blah. Generating story. Okay. You are max bitrate. Punk living in the futuristic city of Zale. You have a bag of drugs and a hollow band. Yeah. You wake up in a dark alley with bruises all over your body. You have no idea what happened. You stand up and see a giant red van driving away. You don't know what that was all about, but you need to get home quickly. There is a low hum coming from your left. You see it closed. Continue. Sign hanging in the door of a nearby building. You walk over and read it. The sign says the drug Clench is now banned in Zale. You remember seeing a bag of the stuff in the van. What do you do?
I think we should take the bag of drugs.
Take the bag of drugs. You take the bag of drugs. The bag of drugs is sitting there in plain view, and you are hungry. You decide to keep the bag of drugs. Clue, clue, a voice says behind you. What do you do?
I say clue, clue back.
Say clue, clue back. Is the implication that we're already supposed to eat the drugs?
I guess. It said that we were hungry.
You say clue clue back. You turn around and see a toy robot. The robot's name is Bob. Howdy, Bob says. I've been waiting here for the clutch seas to arrive. Okay. Proceed. Okay. It seems they have a special delivery for me. They should be here any minute now. You look around and notice the alley is empty. You look at Bob. Are you working? You ask. I'm on break, Bob says. They need me in the warehouse for inventory, but this is a slow day. I generally only work on the weekend. What are the clutch ties? Clutch size? Clutch C's? We gotta nail that down.
I wanna say C's.
Clutch C's. What are the clutch C's? Are you a robot? I'm a clutch cyber. Fuck! Yep. Oh, we are the ruling elite of the city.
Oh my god.
Cyber. The elite ruling class, if you will. The Clutch C's run everything here. I don't know why you've been brought here, but I'm guessing it has something to do with the impending revolution.
Oh, hell story's yeah. Getting spicy.
I like that.
Yeah.
It seems like we're already responding with a quotation.
Yeah. I think we should give Bob the drugs. 'Cause he said he was waiting for a delivery.
Turns out he's like waiting for a bunch of paper clips and he's gonna get really upset.
Yeah.
You give Bob the drugs. You reach into your pocket and pull out the bag of drugs. You have a gun in your other hand, but you figure you can put it away if this goes badly. I mean, what? You would take it out if it goes badly.
Yeah. I think we're just prepared for any situation.
Prepare for any situation.
Oh my goodness.
Like, you enter into the situation and already take your gun out.
Yeah.
You put the bag of drugs in Bob's hand. Hold on to these, you say, just in case. I've got a bun in the oven, Bob says.
Is that some sort of code?
That or Bob is pregnant with like a tiny robot.
Oh my god. We should ask him if that's some sort of code.
Absolutely. Is that some sort of code? No, it's a biological reality. Oh, I guess he is pregnant.
Oh, God.
Well, is there anything you want? I'd like to have my battery replaced. That's it. You walk away from Bob, thinking. Yeah, I'm right there with you. I'm baffled.
Okay, if Bob has a bun in the oven, what does he mean by saying that he wants his battery replaced? Does he literally mean he wants his battery replaced?
Maybe he's just so heartbroken, knowing that he can't be a good parent with all of the robo responsibilities that he has.
Oh my!
He wants to replace his heart for a less robotic one.
Mm.
Or he literally wants like a yeah.
He's just like on low battery, like, hey, can you replace this real quick? Like,
please.
I need help. I'm carrying a child.
Let's reach into our magic bag of drugs and see if we
sure.
can pull out a battery.
Yeah. See
wait.
If we have any batteries on us. Do we carry?
Oh, wait. We pulled out the bag of drugs.
Oh, yeah. We gave it to him.
Let's reach into our pockets and see if we have any batteries.
Mm-hmm.
What have we got? You take out batteries and give one to Bob. Thanks, Bob. I can't believe that worked. Thanks,
I know.
Bob says. No problem, you say. One of these days, I'm going to take over this city, Bob says. Oh.
I think we should shoot Bob.
I think you're right. I think Bob is going to turn like Helios 1.
Yeah.
Shoot Bob.
Oh my god.
You grab your gun and shoot Bob. Thank you. You're very welcome, you say. You put your gun back in your pocket. you walk away from Bob's body.
That was what he wanted. He didn't want a battery. He wanted us to just take him out of his misery.
Maybe he's got his, like, consciousness uploaded to the cloud. Maybe he's literally a ghost in the shell.
Oh, what if we set him free? What if accident? By killing him.
What if... So we didn't really kill him, though. Because in that case, all we killed was the baby.
We killed his body, but his mind...
His mind isn't pregnant, only his body. Try
the
not.
The baby was the only thing tying him to this mortal coil. Oh no. Oh god.
This is already getting into some pretty cyberpunk territory. You try not to think about the fact that you just killed a baby. One of these days, I'm gonna take over the city, Bob says. Is there any particular reason why you'd want to do that, you ask? I don't know, Bob says. Fair enough. High five, Bob.
Yes, high five him.
Yeah, no, clearly Bob is like... You high five, Bob. No, we don't want drugs, you say. We want to have a peaceful protest. So, Bob says?
Does Bob not want a peaceful protest?
Does
Bob want anarchy?
Maybe anarchy is how Bob climbs the ranks.
Maybe.
Anarchy that he runs. Maybe Bob is secretly Dr. Horrible. So clearly this is already broken.
Yeah.
We didn't, like, follow whatever tracks it was trying to set up for us, so now it just...
No.
It's trying to railroad us really hard.
You know what I like to imagine? I imagine we shot Bob, and then we picked up whatever was left of his brain, and he's, like, talking to us through that chip or something.
Yeah, we're, like, carrying him around with him like a, like a Peachczar sidekick.
Oh, yeah. Now we're...
Let's find Bob a new body. You know?
Oh yeah. Yeah, let's do that.
Let's look for a new body for Bob to inhabit. I think Bob is gonna turn out to be like one of those tragic villains.
Yeah, he's already got a tragic backstory already. I mean, we shot him, killed his baby.
Cause like
putting him into a new body.
Exactly. Like there are two ways that this can go. We either accidentally create our own supervillain, or he hangs out with us the entire time. And like the idea that he wants to become evil is hilarious because he can't.
Yes, I like the second one.
Well, luckily...
I hope we go the second route.
Yeah, we didn't have to look very far. We found a small maintenance robot that we stick Bob's body into... What? No, you give him a quick once-over. What do you do?
See if he can give us a ride.
Ask Bob if he can give us a ride.
Because we do want to go home.
Yeah. You ask Bob if he can give you a ride. No, Bob says. Do you know how to get to City Hall? You ask. We need to speak to the mayor about raising the minimum wage. I don't know, Bob says.
Maybe we're not as punk as we thought we are, but you know what? That is pretty punk nowadays.
Yeah, I feel like we're out to start a revolution one way or another.
Oh yeah, for sure. Do we leave Bob behind if he's not going to help us? Or do we...
Ditch Bob.
Yeah.
Get out of here, Bob. If you're not going to help me, I'll find someone else who will. You ditch Bob. No, Bob says. I don't have a ride. Well, do you know how to get to City Hall, you ask? I think so, Bob says. He's just changing his story at this point. He's just moving goalposts.
Mm-hmm. No, he doesn't want to be abandoned. And so he's like, yeah, actually, I can help you.
I think I know the way to City Hall. Please don't leave me for cigarettes.
Let's tell him, let's demand that he give us a ride then, if he knows the way.
I'm going to specify to City Hall.
Yeah.
See if that jogs this thing's memory at least.
Mm-hmm.
You demand that Bob give you a ride to City Hall. I don't have a ride, Bob says. Will you take me to City Hall, you ask? No, Bob says.
Okay, we're leaving Bob for cigarettes. Bob.
Fuck off, Bob. You say, as you abandon Bob for cigarettes.
Yeah.
Fuck off, Bob, you say, as you abandon Bob for cigarettes. Thanks, you say, as you take your cigarettes. You walk away from Bob. No problem, Bob says. I'll just wait around here all day until the real protesters show up.
Oh.
Throwing shade
at
us.
Yeah, he's dissing us.
Well, we can't shoot him. I mean, we can shoot him all day, but it won't kill him.
Yeah.
Just leave Bob to his own devices.
Yeah, maybe he'll turn up later in the story as our villain.
Leave Bob to his own devices and try to find City Hall ourselves. Yeah, ourselves.
Yeah.
You walk around aimlessly, trying to find the mayor's building. I'm imagining the mayor from Powerpuff Girls. You wander the street of the city for a while, but you can't find it. You do find a sandwich shop, though.
Oh, it did say we were hungry earlier. We should get a sandwich.
Absolutely. Go get a sandwich from the sandwich shop.
I imagine it's just like a generic shop. You know, the ones that say, like, salon or laundry?
Yeah.
It's just sandwich shop in neon letters.
Like, when we were playing Spider-Man, and there were so many shops that were just, like, coffee, video.
Yeah.
I would love to go to coffee.
Yes.
You walk into the sandwich shop and buy a chicken salad sandwich from the cashier robot. Hello, the cashier robot says. Would you like to order anything else?
Can we ask it for directions to City Hall?
Yeah, let's do that.
Yeah.
Ask the cashier for directions to City Hall. The directions to City Hall are over there, the cashier robot says, pointing to a map on the wall. Thank you, you say. You leave the sandwich shop and wander the streets once again.
Did we even look at the map?
No. We just fucking walked out of the store. Go back into the shop.
And read the directions.
Look at the map. What are we doing?
I think we got distracted by our sandwich.
To be fair, though, that's pretty understandable.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay, you walk into the shop and look at the map. You notice the route to City Hall. Thank you, you say. You leave the shop and begin to follow the direction. Just completely screw your quest up.
Yeah. We should eat our sandwich while we go to City Hall.
You got it. Messing up my pronouns here.
It's all good.
All mixed up. You eat your sandwich as you go to City Hall. Thanks, you say as you finish the sandwich. You walk to City Hall.
The sandwich wrapper says, thank you for enjoying your sandwich.
It's like nice cream. It's you eat the whole popsicle and then it has like a joke written on it.
Yeah.
You walk to City Hall, you notice that City Hall is quite a walk away from where you are. I need to start jogging, you think to yourself. I'm getting old and I don't get much exercise.
Ah. Getting some exposition on ourselves.
Lament your old age. Thanks, you say as you finish the sandwich. You finish your sandwich and begin to feel sick. You hold your stomach as you vomit all over the sidewalk. That's not quite what I meant, but I'll take it. I think the sandwich was maybe made.
Do you think it was poisoned? Maybe Bob got to it first.
Yeah, Bob injected it with nanomachines.
Yeah.
Check the previous contents of your stomach for poison. Your stomach has been empty for some time, and the last bit of food you ate was hours ago. Fuck off! There isn't anything left in your stomach to poison yourself with! I'm not gonna make it.
Oh no, we're gonna die. Is there a 911 in this city?
Let's call for 911.
Yeah.
Call for 911. I mean, there's a city hall, so you would hope.
Yeah, you would hope.
You get on the phone with 911.
Okay.
Proceed. I ate a sandwich and I'm not feeling well. I think there's poison in it. Where are you? The operator asks. I'm on...
I'm on Street.
Street. You say.
Imagine the whole area that we're in is just all generic.
Yeah. I'm imagining like Main Street USA like in Disneyland, but
yeah.
Everything is like run down.
Yeah.
Street, you say. Okay, what's your name? The operator asks. I'm Steve, you say. I'm not feeling well. There's poison in my stomach. Do you know where you are?
Sandwich shop.
Street. Outside the sandwich shop. You're not being very helpful, operator. Street. Outside the sandwich shop. Okay, stay on the phone with me. I'm sending someone over. You wait patiently for a few minutes, but no one arrives.
Oh, damn. What if the operator is just a robot, too?
Well, you know what happened is the operator and the police are, they're all run by the man. This is a government institution. They're not going to help a cyberpunk out.
Oh, that's right. Let's see. We should crawl back into the sandwich shop.
That's quite a vision.
Yeah. Especially with the classical music in the background.
Crawl back into the sandwich shop. Looking for help. Help. Someone help.
Oh no, Bob.
Damn
Bob
it.
Is here.
Bob. You crawl back into the sandwich shop looking for help. You walk back into the sandwich shop. Bob is still at the cashier robot and hasn't noticed you. Hey, you say. Hey, Bob says, looking up. You feeling okay?
Bob, you bitch, you poisoned me.
He totally poisoned us.
Yeah, he did.
You stagger over to Bob and point to the sandwich shop's name on the building. Bob, you bitch, you poisoned me. Proceed. That sandwich shop poisoned me, you say. Get over there and get help. Bob leaves his post and walks over to the sandwich shop. I think it's implying here that Bob's, like, consciousness has been uploaded to the network. And he is all of the robots.
Oh no, he's jumping between each robot.
Man, I just watched Summer Wars, and that's a bad situation to be in.
Yeah, oh yeah. Bob is everywhere.
So he teleported out of the sandwich shop to arrive at the same sandwich shop.
Yeah, no, he just did it for dramatic effect.
He just walked out and then walked back in.
Yeah. We should ask him for an antidote.
Yeah, let's do that. Ask Bob for an antidote. AA antidote.
Antidote.
My name is Steve, and I've been poisoned. Hi, Steve.
Please, God help.
I need an antidote, you say. Can you get me one? The shop that poisoned you is over there, Bob says, pointing over his shoulder. Like, he's pointing backwards, like, into the rest of the building.
Yeah. Either that or there's another sandwich shop across the street and we crawled into the wrong one.
We were, like, so distraught by the vomiting and the poison that we didn't notice it were two different shops.
Yeah, but they both look the same.
I guess let's go to the other sandwich shop.
All right, let's crawl to the other sandwich shop.
I know, it's the music, right? How's AI doing? It's mind-blowingly good, I think.
Oh yeah, definitely.
You crawl over to the sandwich shop that Bob has been working at. You stumble to your feet and start crawling towards the door. Yeah, he's working at all of them.
Oh my goodness. He's everywhere.
God damn it, Bob. Give me the antidote.
We haul ourselves up onto the counter and we're sweating.
God damn it, Bob. Give me the antidote. What do I need it for? Bob asks. You don't need it.
I need it.
You don't need it. I need it. You crawl to the sandwich shop and stand up. Bob looks confused. Who are you? Bob asks. What do you want?
No.
He's a serious. You start laughing.
We're getting delirious.
Oh man.
I think Bob jumped out of the body and is gone.
Bob? Yep. No, he's just surfing. He's just surfing the soul web.
Let's see. We should shake the robot.
Shake the robot.
Grab it by its collar.
Listen here, you metal punk. He needs the adult. You shake the robot, but nothing happens.
Shake him harder. Maybe he'll drop something.
Shake him harder. What a mess. What a mess already. You continue to shake the robot. Bob's eyes grow wide as his face grows pale. You need to be filled with poison, Bob screams. I need the adult.
I imagine this, if this was a short film, right now, like, the camera effect would be all wibbly because we're just devolving into, like, I don't know, like a drug space or delirium.
There's a scene in one of the few scenes that I like in Red Dead 2 is the one where they all get drunk and have a night out and the camera
that scene is great.
It just keeps like shifting between different hours of the night.
Yes. And nothing they're saying makes any sense.
Give me the adult. I guess if we need the adult, give me the adult.
Yeah, true.
Give me the adult. He needs the adult. You continue to shake Bob as his screams for help grow louder. excuse me. Okay.
No, this is good. I feel like at this point, we'd probably pass out.
Pass out.
Like, his screams just drown us out.
Pass out from dehydration.
Yeah.
You pass out from the lack of water. The AI doesn't know what to say. Yeah, me either, buddy.
Oh, maybe that's where Max Bitrate's story ends. I don't know.
What if we... And here's what I'm thinking, right?
Yeah.
What if we wake up in the hospital?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Let's do it. Let's wake up in the hospital.
I find a lot of the time with these types of games, if it doesn't know what to do and you just... Oh, God damn it, Bob.
Oh, God.
You wake up in the hospital with your head feeling fuzzy. You notice Bob sitting in a chair, hooked up to various IVs and IV bags.
Oh, no. He's monitoring our medicine.
No, Bob is in the system.
Uh-huh. He's our little, you know that little machine that they hook up everything to? That's him. He's in it.
Oh my God, JC. A Bob.
Who's JC? Oh, Jesus Christ. Gotcha.
JC is JC Denton. The main character of the original Deus Ex game.
Okay. Gotcha.
So that game had really bad voice acting, just while we're off on a tangent. And one of the most famous lines from that is the dude calling you over the radio and being like, "Oh my God, JC, a bomb." And JC looks at him and says, "A bomb?" That's just... It's just like that flat tone the entire time.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
"Oh my God, JC, a bomb," you say. "He's been like this ever since the trial," a nurse says, walking into the room. "He won't wake up. We've tried everything."
Oh no. Oh God, we got a mystery here.
Ask about the trial.
Yeah.
Oop, I think I misspelled nurse.
You ask the noose about the trial.
They call me the noose. Why do they call you that? "What do you remember from the trial?" the nurse asks. "There was a trail," you say. "It was for a sandwich shop. It was for Bob." What happened at the trial? That's what I'm trying to say. "That's what I'm wondering," you say. Okay, yeah. "They found him guilty," the nurse says. "They gave him a sentence of death." I think that's quite how you phrase that. "For what?" you ask. "I don't understand. He poisoned someone," the nurse says.
Oh my God. What if we're just imagining Bob is there? What if he's just in our head?
Says Bob.
What if we're a detective and Bob is just, I don't know, in our head?
Does Bob exist? "Does Bob exist?" you ask. "He exists," the nurse says. "I don't understand," you say. "I'll be over here if you need me," the nurse says, walking out of the room.
She's like, okay, this guy's crazy.
Oh, that's not good. That's not good at all.
We should ask Bob what's going on.
Yeah. Ask Bob what's going on. Bob.
Ooh, can I voice Bob?
Go for it.
Okay. "Who is that?" Bob asks.
"It's me," you say. "What's going on?"
"The trial?"
Yeah. Trial. Tell me about it. Yeah, the trial. Tell me about it.
"Oh," Bob says. "I don't remember much. I remember there was a trail. They asked me some questions. They found me guilty."
Trail. Guilty of poison in the first degree? You son of a bitch. G- guilty of poison in the first degree, you son of a bitch?
That's what I heard, Bob says. I don't remember.
That's a lie, you say.
I'm not lying, Bob says. I don't remember.
Proceed.
I don't remember. They said they'd give me a lethal injection if I didn't tell the truth. Then I passed out.
Who won, you ask?
I don't know. I don't remember, Bob says. I need to eat.
Maybe you should eat a sandwich.
Turn it back on him.
Maybe you should eat a sandwich.
I need to eat, Bob says. Can you get me a sandwich?
You walk over to the sandwich shop and get yourself a BLT and bring it back to Bob. Feed.
Guess we're not Bob. Doing so bad.
I guess not. We were fine. We could have just walked up and left. Like, they didn't even try to stop us.
No.
You feed Bob. You put the sandwich in Bob's hand. He tries to grab it, but his hand touches the palm of your own.
That's cold, he says.
Oh, I think I see where this is going.
Are we a robot?
Are we a robot and Bob was a human the whole time?
Oh no! I think that's what it is.
That's because I'm a robot, Bob. Damn. That's because I'm a robot, Bob.
I need to warm up, Bob says.
You put your palm against his forehead. He shivers. Are you cold, Bob? You ask.
I need to warm up, Bob says.
Oh, poor Bob. I think
Bob's just a guy.
Bob is just like a mentally not well person.
Yeah.
And we've been a secret robot this whole time.
Yeah. He tried to get rid of us because we've been, like, just leaving him out in the dust, cold, and, like, harming him. And he's just like, please, I just want to live.
Give Bob a blanket. And
aww.
Leave. We haven't learned anything yet.
No.
You give Bob a blanket and leave. You walk over to your room and grab a blanket from the closet. You lay it over Bob.
Thanks, he says.
Domo arigato. You mean. Sticks would be proud. Domo arigato, you mean.
You're welcome, Tom. Bob says.
The nurse walks in. Hey, I'm Dr. Kessel, he says, shaking your hand.
Are we just in a mental asylum? I think we are.
Ask Dr. Kessel if we are in a mental institution. Yeah, this is getting interesting.
Because
we have no concept of who's real and who's a figment of our imagination.
Uh-huh.
You ask Dr. Kessel if you are in a mental institution. No, we just got a new patient, he says. I have a hypothetical situation, you say. What? he asks.
Hypothetically, I got poisoned by a sandwich.
Hypothetically.
Given to me by a robot.
I was, hypothetically speaking, let's say I was given a poisoned sandwich by a robot and woke up in a hospital. What would you do? Yeah, hypothetically, let's say I was given a poisoned sandwich by a robot and woke up in a hospital. What would you do? I'd try to find out what had happened and who was behind it, he says. Exactly, you say. So you're not in a mental institution, he asks. Don't know, man, you're the nurse.
No, let's get cheesy. Let's just say... Oh, Sanity is my middle name. I don't know.
Sanity is my middle name. You say... Like, giving him the thumbs up, like, double thumbs up.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Sanity is my middle name, you say. I'm not sure, you say. So, you're not sure if you're in a mental institution, he asks?
Aren't we all in a mental institution?
Stare blankly at the nurse. Attempt to leave. Had enough of this day.
I know.
You stare blankly at the nurse. You stare blankly at the nurse, then attempt to leave. You stare at the nurse before looking at Dr. Kessel. Is he nuts? Dr. Kessel asks.
Imagine
nuts
he needs
bolts, baby. What's that?
I imagine him putting up his clipboard and just whispering to the nurse, like, is this guy crazy?
What is this guy? He's not even on our roster. How did he get here?
I love your answer, though. Nuts and bolts, baby.
Nuts and bolts, baby.
I'm not sure, you say. What would convince you, the doctor asks. You think for a moment.
Nuts and bolts?
Bolts? This is turning into a Joss Whedon script.
Yeah, absolutely.
Nuts and bolts? Alright, how about the fact that I work at a mental institution? He asks. You nod. Fair, he says. You know
so
what we should
do? We are in a mental... What? What should we do?
We should ask him for directions to City Hall. Because we still
have... Oh my god, yes. Yes, ask him.
Ask Dr. Kessel. For directions to City Hall.
City Hall, baby! Let's go!
Woo!
It's just down the road, Dr. Kessel says. You can't miss it. How far is it, you ask? About 10 miles, he says.
Where are we? Are we in the country?
Like, I guess. Or maybe it's just like a really big city.
Oh, maybe. Yeah, you're right. It is a cyberpunk city.
Let's walk 10 miles. And enter City Hall. You walk 10 miles down the road and enter City Hall. You walk into the City Hall. It's an enormous building made of a light tan stone. The City Hall has two huge towers, made of a dark gray stone, topped with small golden spires.
I guess we should ask for the mayor, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yes. And we still need to eat.
I don't know. We tried eating. Ask for the mayor. Ask if he has any food. Don't try this, ever. Don't, like, walk into City Hall and just ask if people have food. They'll probably just shoot you.
Or kick you out, yeah.
You ask for the mayor. Ask if he has any food. The mayor? The attendant asks. Yeah, the mayor, you say. I'm sorry, but we don't give out that information, he says.
That's fair. That's a logical answer.
Yeah, I agree. It's fair. Logical answer, you say, scoping out the room. You sit down in a random chair.
let's wait for the mayor.
Yeah, let's ambush him as soon as he leaves.
Yeah. Wait for him to walk out the door.
Wait for the mayor. Wait for the major. Oh, that's a different cyberpunk thing. I'm gonna wait for Major Kusanagi. Wait for the mayor. Oh man, what if the major showed up?
That would be sick.
Wait for the mayor. Try not to pass out this time.
Oh yeah.
You wait patiently in the large empty room. After a few minutes, a man walks into the room. He walks up to you.
May I help you?
Yes. I have a message for the mayor, you say.
What's your name?
He asks. Thomas! Oh! Tomas, you say.
And what do you want from the mayor?
Food. Answers. Food. And answers.
What do you want from the mayor?
The man asks. I want food, you say.
And?
And what?
And?
And answers. You scream. You have no idea the kind of day I've had. I want answers, you say.
All right, follow me,
says, before walking off. You follow the man through the hallways of the building. He stops at a door with an intercom. Okay.
Here we are,
he says. He pushes the button on the intercom and a voice crackles through, asking what he wants.
Food.
He says, the door opens.
What if it's a code word?
Yeah. I'm picturing, like, either it's a code word and we've stumbled into the mystery, or he's about to open, like... You ever see Richie Rich?
No, I haven't.
Well, imagine he's going to open a door and it's just going to be like the coolest rumpus room you've ever seen with like an LCD TV and just piles of food everywhere.
Oh, that would be fantastic.
Walk in through the door.
I think that would be heaven for our poor Tomas.
Poor Tomas. You walk into the room and find yourself faced with a dozen soldiers holding automatic weapons. Shit!
Tomas, you're under arrest for treason. You have the right to remain silent.
Okay. Okay.
Do you want to make a statement?
Soldier asks. Yeah, you say. You take a deep breath.
Oh. The cheesiest comeback. Let's go. Oh God.
This has got to.
What do we say?
Let's see. Okay. We walked in through a door. Dozen soldiers.
Twelve against one. Sounds like fair odds.
You
well,
say,
yeah, we still have the gun in our pocket.
Yeah. And take the gun out of your pocket.
Yes. Let's get some cyberpunk action up in here.
Firing at the soldiers. From the hip.
Ooh.
12 against 1. Sounds like fair odds, you say, and take the gun out of your pocket, firing at the soldiers from the hip. You pull out your gun, firing at the soldiers. You manage to kill 3 of them before they open fire on you. Damn! A bullet hits you in the head and you fall to the ground.
Is this where we reveal if we're a robot?
I think so. Get up.
Oh!
Inspect wound. You feel a bit dizzy. You realize you're losing blood, and the pain is great.
Not that there's a lot of pain, but the pain feels great.
I mean, you can get hit in the head with like a football and it hurts.
Yeah. I imagine he's like, yes, I'm alive.
Yes. Number 5 is alive. this guy is such an asshole. Yes, number 5 is alive, you say.
Can you walk?
Soldier asks. I'll try, you say. You take a shaky step forward.
Come on, don't die. Oh, did we transfer our consciousness into another soldier?
That would be awesome.
I think we did. That's what I'm imagining anyways.
Become a soldier. You are now... What's our new name?
Jameson Jones.
Jameson Jones. You are now Jameson Jones. 34. Father of none. You become a soldier. You are now Jameson Jones, 34, father of none, transferred over the soul net. You spend your last few hours as a free man, wondering if you made the right choice.
We're regretting taking over this man's life.
Yeah. Because once we leave his body, I think his body will it'll just die.
Yeah. He won't be able to handle living without us.
Regret nothing. And go for another sandwich.
Yes!
Hopefully this one won't be poisoned.
Yeah, absolutely.
You walk up to the sandwich bar and order a turkey and Swiss on wheat bread. You find a seat in the corner and begin eating.
A man and body of culture.
Absolutely.
I think we should savor... Oh.
Savor these moments.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
You make yourself at home, ordering several more sandwiches as you try to decide on your next move.
We are a hungry, hungry man.
Well, you know, Jameson Jones, 34, father of none, is... He's got to keep up his calorie intake.
Yeah,
he's a strong guy.
Yeah, he's like absolutely like ripped underneath all of that that bulletproof armor.
He's like a Clark Kent type.
Yeah. Working for the man.
Try one last time to see your family.
Oh God.
It's only one day until retirement. You pull out your phone and send a quick text to your family. Sorry. You spend the rest of... Fuck!
No!
That's awesome! It's incredible!
I feel like that's where our story ends.
You spend the rest of your life in the police force. Hell yeah!
I think that's perfect!
That is awesome.
That was incredible. That was an incredible story.
You haven't seen your family in years, and you send them one text before never talking to them again, and it just says sorry.
Oh, what if it's the government just like, yeah, no, you've reached your limit for like the rest of your life in texts, and you can just never talk to them again.
Yeah. They keep your...
Yeah. And you just live out the rest of your life.
Like a slave to the man.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's going to close out one of them. Do you want to go for a second campaign or do you want to leave it here?
Yeah, no, I'm jazzed up for a second one. That one ended fantastically.
Shit. Oh, I love that. Sorry.
That was amazing.
Okay.
I think you should choose this one. I chose the last one.
Here's the problem with this, right?
Yeah.
I really would like to do mystery, but I've tried mystery so many times, and I think that the options they give you for that really suck.
Okay.
I say we go for fantasy.
Yeah. Fantasy's perfect.
Number one. Select a character. We can be a noble, a knight, a squire, a wizard, a ranger, a peasant, or a rogue. I kind of want to be a ranger because then we get to be Viggo Mortensen.
Oh, yeah. That sounds good.
He gave one of his co-stars a horse because he was rich enough to do it.
He's such a cool guy.
How cool is that?
Yeah.
Our character's name. I'm going to leave the name up to you this time because I grabbed the name the last time.
Okay. Let's see.
I'm just thinking about the text. I'm sorry.
I think we should be Eric Locksworthy.
Eric Locksworthy.
Yeah.
Generating story. You are Eric Locksworthy, a ranger living in the kingdom of Larian. You have a hunting bow and a quiver of arrows. Hell yeah. You have been searching for a mystical beast for 3 months, tracking it through the forest. As you crouch behind a clump of trees, you see movement. As the sun shines through the leaves, you see the creature clearly. It's a strange kind of bear with sharp claws and a large bushy tail. What do you do?
Drink a potion and shoot it with our arrows.
You quickly drink a potion down and grab your bow. You notch an arrow in the bow and take aim. The creature charges towards you. You let the arrow fly, but miss.
Oh no. Dodge out of the way.
Dodge out of the way. You backpedal out of the way, but the creature is faster and smacks into you. It turns you over and your stomach flips as it slams you to the ground, breaking several bones.
Oh, Jesus.
Wow, right off the bat.
Let's crawl over to our sword. We're gonna do more crawling.
Your sword. You crawl over to your sword, but you are much too weak. The creature walks over to you and bends down to tear off your head with its sharp claws.
Oh, he died already.
Oh, no. See, it's only walked over and bent down to do it.
Ah, but it hasn't done it yet.
We have one chance.
One opportunity.
Chance, and that's what we got. To own it.
Yeah.
Better never let it go.
Mom spaghetti. You know what? Let's throw Mom's spaghetti in its face.
Throw Mom's spaghetti in its face. Own your moment. Oh,
hold on.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh,
gotta fix that.
Come on, Eminem. Don't fail us now. You grab the handle of your sword and try to pull it out of the ground, but you are too weak. You hear a crunch and then a roar.
Oh, is our sword named Mom Spaghetti?
I guess.
That's fantastic.
So.
Look to see what crunched.
Look to see what crunched.
It's probably our bones, but we should look anyways.
Well, he's nervous, all right? His knees are weak and his palms are sweaty. Of course he's not going to be able to grab the sword.
Oh yeah, of course.
You look over and see your reflection in the creature's eye. Its face looks like a demon's face with a large snout, blood-red eyes, and sharp teeth. The creature growls and then runs away.
Wonder why it ran away.
That's right. I ran away. I'm just imagining him, like, spluttering out his own blood and being like, yeah, you run. You better run. It seems your small act of defiance caused the creature to run. You are too weak to follow it, but hope that one day you will find it again. You've been killed by a demon. Shit.
I guess we just, like, died in our own puddle of blood as it ran away.
What if we...
Mom's spaghetti couldn't save us. Oh, what are you gonna say?
What if this is one of those situations... Because, like, when they talked about this thing, I kind of imagined, like, a Balverine killed us. So what if this turns us into a Balverine?
Oh, yeah.
Awaken. As Demon Reborn.
Hell yeah.
You awaken strapped to a bed. You notice the room is decorated with a white and red color scheme, similar to the demon you just faced. Two figures enter the room. Okay.
Finally awake, huh?
One is a well-dressed man with black hair and sharp features. He wears a red robe with a black talisman hanging from it. The other is a beautiful but pale woman with long blonde hair.
Ask what's going on?
What's going on? You ask. How you doing? What's going on, you ask. The man smiles.
Finally, you's wised up.
Oh. Okay. See, this is what I was looking for in the mystery.
Yeah.
Last time I tried a mystery, it turned into the Star Wars.
Really?
Yeah.
That's
finally,
hilarious.
You's wised up.
Finally, you's wised up.
You want I should get up? You ask?
You want I should get up? You ask?
If you please.
He says, bowing his head. You get up and stand before the man. What's a demon gotta do to get a cold drink around here? You say. You ask. What's a demon gotta do to get a cold drink around here? You ask. The woman frowns.
So you've awoken. Good.
Proceed.
I was hoping you'd be up and about soon. Unfortunately, I don't think you're going to like what I have to tell you.
Let's just get on with it then, you say.
Very well.
The man says. The woman looks at you.
Your name is Karth.
No, it's not.
That's your demon name. That's our demon name.
Yeah, okay.
You're the last... Okay, maybe not. You're the last of the Uwais tribe.
What's that? You ask. In an awful accent.
Ayug! What's that?
You ask in an awful accent. The man smiles.
I am the master and this is the nurse.
We are the last few humans in this building. The others died or fled long ago. So, do you remember anything?
Me da? Me da, you say. The woman nods.
Yes, and his name is Calpurnia. She was one of your scouts.
What? You ask? Confused? I just woke up.
What? You ask, confused? I just woke up.
The man frowns.
Now you've been asleep for quite some time. When the demons attacked your village, you were injured and taken to one of our safe houses. You were then sent here after recovering. So you're
That's
not a demon.
What I did? Recovered? Am I good? Am I back to demon fighting shape? The woman nods.
The woman... Yes, you've had a fever and were heavily sedated. Even now you're still not completely awake. You fought off the demons and saved our asses.
Who's us? Who's this us you guys is talking about?
What's this suddenly us about?
The human race, the man smiles. We're a tiny community of humans that live in this building. The Norse and I are the only ones left, though, there are other humans elsewhere in the city.
I think he's got more.
Uh-huh. The rest of the humans in the city died, and this building became our safe haven. I'm not sure how long we can hold off the demons. I'm starting to go country here.
It's okay, these are the last remnants of humanity.
If the other safe houses fall, we're dead.
So, why'd you save me?
We needed someone to help defend us, the man shrugs. You were the only one left. The Norse was doubtful about saving you. She thought you were dead. I just prayed to Yag that you'd live, and it seems Yag heard my prayers because you did.
You frown. Why? Why are we frowning?
How come you're the master and she's the Norse?
The master is high up in the community, the woman explains. But the name Norse comes from the old berserker tradition.
Oh yeah, I think I hoid heard about that. They actually do a pretty good job with that and that.
Yeah.
Next quest, kill a mythical beast.
Uh-oh.
Oh yeah, I think I heard about that.
Man nods. Yeah, we berserkers bonded together to fight off the hordes of demons. It's probably why we're so numerous.
Yeah, well, if yous guys, yeah, I'm confused too. I don't know what's going on here.
Because first we have a lot of people, then we have like no people, then we're numerous.
Yeah, well, if you guys is so numerous or whatever, how's come you guys dead?
Yeah, I doesn't know what to say.
How about we're just like, you know what? I'm just gonna leave.
Leave.
Just
attempt to find the beast. It's time to take some action, boys. It's time to follow me. You leave the room and begin to look around. You find yourself in a large hall filled with beds.
beds that are now empty.
Jump on every bed.
Oh yeah. Jump on every bed. The floor is lava.
Yeah.
You jump on every bed. You find yourself half lying on top of a boy. God damn it. I'm not sure what you want, the boy says, but he's dead.
I want to say they're not really dead. They're just all pretending to be dead.
The AI doesn't know what to say either.
If you're as dead, how come you's in bed?
If you's dead, how come you's is in bed?
Go ahead. You want to take the boy?
Yeah, I'll take the boy.
Go for it.
The boy says, looking at you, I think this is
what? The boy looks around nervously.
A casket?
A casket? But why are you in a casket?
Because I died.
Yeah, me too, I guess. Makes sense. Let's try and get out of here.
Yeah.
We gotta find this mythical beast.
Yeah.
Yeah, me too, I guess. Makes sense, you say, as you attempt to leave again. The boy grabs your arm.
You can't go yet. They're coming for us.
Who? Who's this? This. Us.
I should really be doing the one parenthesis in there, but I keep forgetting.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's okay.
Who's this? Us.
The beasts, of course.
Yeah, I know about the beasts. I fought some.
Nah, I mean the true beasts, the demons. They'll be here soon.
Yeah, I fought some.
You insist. You then wait for the demons. I guess if we're gonna fight and they're coming here, we might as well wait, right?
Yeah, might as well wait for them.
Yeah, I fought some, you insist, then wait for the demons. The boy waits for you to leave.
Don't worry, they won't get us.
You begin walking away again. Yeah, whatever.
I think we should arm ourselves.
Okay. Arm yourself with weapons. And armor. We need armor this time.
Yeah, definitely.
Last time we got messed up.
We got wrecked.
We got worked real fast. You arm yourself with weapons and armor. You walk to a bed and grab some armor and weapons. Saw you's dead, but they come for us. Why?
The demons want our flesh to summon them to the infernal realms.
Damn. Okay.
They'll be here soon.
Oh, welcome, Miranda. Welcome. You turn. Yeah, I fought some. Look, I'm not a killer, so do we stop with the heavy talk and just have some fun? I mean, I guess you're not a killer. You got killed. Oh, no.
No. He wants to do something else with them demons.
Abort! Leave! Never return!
The boy grabs your hand. Come on, I'll show you around.
You abort! Leave! Never return! You quickly turn, grabbing your blade. You slash the throat of the boy who grabs you. You then begin tearing him apart, feasting on his flesh. We're being attacked! A voice screams.
They brought out the demon inside of you.
Shit. This has turned into, like, a Witcher side quest, only we're not Geralt.
Yeah, we're the demon. This is before Geralt shows up.
Oh, no. You say. I guess I'm the demon. The demon.
Demon.
Oh no, you say. I guess I'm the demon. You look at your reflection in the metal. You see the beast inside you unleashed. You hack off an arm and a leg, feasting on flesh.
It's like an anime moment where you just see yourself reflected in your weapon.
Jibun, whoa. Yeah, it's bad.
Yeah. Just like my master told me.
Get ready, I guess, ready yourself to fight?
Ready yourself for demonic combat.
Hell yeah.
You laugh, slicing through a couple more demons. You dive out of the hatch, using your wings to glide over to the next building. You swing yourself up to the roof and begin hacking away at the demons. Hell yeah.
This got
real metal real fast.
Uh-huh.
You know what that was? That thing with the kid?
Yeah.
That was like when you're watching like a super edgy demon fighting show or whatever, and they try to do the one shock value thing.
Oh, yeah.
And then like they swerve it at the last second. They're like, we can't show that on network TV.
Yeah. And then they just immediately dive into, like, a super gory badass fight.
Yeah, Evanescence is totally playing here, and I love it.
Yes. Wake me up inside.
In fact, I'm going to tell you what. I'm going to go to BRB real quick.
Okay.
And then when we come back...
Mm-hmm.
What we're gonna do instead is we're gonna do
Hell yeah. Oh no
Hell yeah.
Oh no
You gotta turn this low so it doesn't catch on the mute on the VOD though.
Gotcha. Oh god. Chat, you'll understand once you start listening.
Okay. We need to kill these demons.
Oh my god. Yeah.
Kill the demons.
Our network station couldn't afford the real Evanescence, so we got Kids Bop up in here.
In fact, let me transition one more time.
Mm-hmm.
My house now smells like burnt popcorn, and it's a little surprising.
Oh god, it's the demons.
Alright, you slash the demon, cutting off its arm. You quickly hack it to pieces for food before another group of demons arrives.
Oh, hell yeah. Swing around and slice them.
Swing around and slice them. Slice them all. We need to end this before it begins.
Yes.
You let out a fearsome roar, hacking at a demon's neck and beheading it. You let out a triumphant roar, hacking at the demons. As you hack through the horde of demons, you notice a few remaining.
Consume them.
Consume them. Consume. Let out a fearsome roar, hacking at the two remaining demons. You hack through both their heads, beheading them both. They fall to the ground dead. You are victorious.
Feast on their corpses.
Feast on their corpses.
Oh, and let out a roar.
Oh, we'll let out a roar on the next go around.
Yeah.
You quickly hack through the corpse of the two demons you killed. They really like this hack through the corpse terminology.
Yeah.
You quickly consume them, eating the delicious flesh that seems to strengthen you.
Let out a roar!
And keep consuming flesh. Growing in strength. Wow.
Hell yeah.
Oh god, this song is so bad. You continue to hack and consume, letting out a fearsome roar that could shake the very heavens. You hack through the corpses, growing in power and strength. Your body becomes more muscled, your feathers more powerful.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Alright.
Let's see. The song is bad, but strangely it works.
They didn't do the scream because they knew the guy couldn't do the scream. I can't wait, go! Double back to attack the humans.
Oh yeah, wipe out the humans.
New demonic power. We need to bring us to life.
Yes.
You double back to attack the humans using your new demonic power. You roar, flying toward the building you came from. You dive down, easily destroying the building with your immense strength and power. You slam into a man, knocking him into the next town. Oh, damn.
That's like a comedic moment right there.
It's like Team Rocket.
Yeah.
Okay, no. We're doing All Star by the Kids Bop version. You know what? How about we do? If you need to do it, we'll do this. Mm-hmm. Knocking him into the next town. Team Rocket, blasting off again. You say.
Is this Goofy?
Yeah, it's Goofy. Goofy sings Evanescence. You begin firing of laser beams, melting through the roof and setting the place alight. The man you knocked into the building screams as he's set alight, running around in a panic.
Oh, that's a vision.
Hell yeah.
That's cool. I can't with the Goofy.
Garsh, you say. As you continue your assault on the last vestiges of man. You begin slamming into people, knocking them through buildings or into the flames that now engulf the town. You easily smash through a wall, killing a man as he screamed.
Oh god. Is there a version where Goofy sings into the fire and flames?
I don't know, but we can find that out. You know what? Let's take a look behind the curtain here and let's see what we can find, shall we?
Yeah.
Let's see. Goofy sings through... Wake up! Save me! Hell yeah. Doesn't look like it.
Oh, dang.
Which is unfortunate.
If any of you out there are good at music editing, that needs to be done.
Absolutely.
Please and thank you.
Okay, I'll stop here. Where's Maxie? You scream into the night air. Okay, and enough of town goof. Now let's turn our classical domain back on, shall we?
All right. Yeah.
Because I feel like if anything's gonna get VOD muted, it's probably Uptown Anything.
Yeah, for sure.
Where's Maxie? You scream into the night air. You begin firing laser beams at the men who tried to hold out in the town's cafe. You set the place alight, and there's nothing anyone can do.
Order a coffee.
Yeah, I can get down with that.
Yeah.
Coffee.
Take a short break from all the killing and feasting and get yourself a nice coffee.
The barista appears holding a coffee.
What can I get for you, sir?
She asks politely.
I imagine she's just like, she sees this shit all the time, and she's just like, okay. What do you want?
I'm gonna toss in a Ziltoid reference here.
Okay.
Bring me your universe's ultimate cup of coffee.
I imagine as a demon, we talk in all caps. Like it's this booming voice.
Yeah.
Bring me your universe's ultimate cup of coffee.
The barista looks at you. go for it.
The barista looks at you nervously. We don't have any milk or sugar or anything like that.
That's good. I'll just take it black.
Like my soul.
Like my soul.
The barista nods, grabbing the black cup of coffee and setting it down in front of you.
Sip it.
Sip it. Contentedly. I like the idea that, like, the coffee shop is totally fine through all this.
Yeah.
You grab the coffee, drinking the black liquid down your throat. That's a very strange way to put that, game. But I'll take it. It's absolutely delicious. You sigh in contentment as you feel... Okay, I'm sorry, I read that for a second as contempt. Sigh in contentment as you feel a wave of energy hit you.
All right, I think we're ready to go back out on the town.
Let's paint the town red.
You say. Bursting through the plate glass window.
The coffee shop.
Newly caffeinated. That's not how you spell caffeinated. Thanks.
Yeah, there you go.
Let's paint the town red,
you say, bursting through the plate glass window and resuming your attack, newly caffeinated. You begin firing your laser, melting the place shut. The barista screams as she's fried to a crisp. Aww. The rest of the humans are no match for you.
Damn it. She was a good barista, too.
Damn it.
Say, I actually liked her.
I actually liked her.
You lament.
I was aiming for the other guy.
You walk over to the man that's still screaming with the burning chest wound. You grab him by the shirt collar and begin to drag him through the flaming cafe out the back door. Damn.
Dang, that's a moment. Let's see. We should ask him for directions to City Hall.
Ask the man. Ask the screaming man for directions to City Hall. Tip, AI Dungeon is a lot smarter than old text adventures.
Yeah.
You ask the screaming man for directions to City Hall. No, please, the man screams. I'm dying, can't you see? I need to get to a hospital.
There's no hospital where you're going.
Absolutely. You reply.
Hell yeah.
There's no need for a hospital where you're going.
You reply. The man's eyes widen as he realizes where you're taking him. You're going to kill me, aren't you? That's why you brought me here. You're a criminal, a murderer. You look at the man and snarl.
Damn right I am.
Damn right I am.
You grab the man and drop him over the banister. You hear a snap. Oh, Javert, no! And you pull the man down, dropping him onto the ground.
Ah, looks like we've got to find someone else to ask for directions.
look for directions elsewhere.
Is there an information shop, maybe?
Can you give me instructions to how to get to the direction shop?
You find a pile of garbage. Oh, hey, it's me. Lying on the ground.
You grab it,
tossing it into the air. The man screams as the garbage ignites in a spectacular fireball.
Oh no, there's a guy in the garbage.
Fuego, you say.
You fire off another laser, melting through the side of a building. You quickly move through the night, setting alight a police station. Yeah.
Dang.
Man. What were we supposed to be trying to kill a demon, and all we did was kill a bunch of humans.
Yeah, no, I think we became the demon. We became what we feared most.
Hmm. Reflect upon your demonic nature. Sulkingly.
Sulking.
That's not a word. Sulking. You are Max, demon of fear. Your abilities are such that you can take the fear of others and amplify it, strengthening yourself. It's your real name. Are we a Nagloshi? Are we a skinwalker?
That sounds kind of cool. We're one with wings, that's for sure.
See, this is interesting. This is all tying together because originally we were Max and we didn't know who we were. Then we thought we knew who we were, but we were looking for Maxie. And it turns out Max was within us the entire time.
Ah, he was our demon. And now we have become him.
Hmm. Take up holy arms and vanquish the demon within. I don't know why I almost turned that into a quote. You take up holy arms and vanquish the demon within. You're not a demon. You're a human. A normal human with a fear of clowns. If you die here, it's because you faced your fears and died. Can't argue with that, I guess.
Yeah, no. Look, observe the destruction around us.
Observe. There's not a police officer or a military person alive tonight. This is your city now. You rule it with an iron fist. Suddenly, a siren begins to wail. It's an alarm.
Woo-wee-woo-wee-woo-wee.
Whoop, whoop, that's the sound of the police. Whoop, whoop, that's the sound of the beast.
Wee-woo-wee-woo.
Oh, yeah.
Clutching your radio. Yes.
And let's fix that.
Wee woo, wee woo.
You say, with clutching your radio with tears in your eyes, I have to save the world. The television screen flicks on, showing a live feed of the city. The government is having a news station on in case of emergencies. Yeah, just in case, I guess.
What is the news saying?
Watch the news for information. Please furnish me with these informations. The news show begins. A reporter is speaking into the camera.
We should listen and see what the reporter is saying.
A criminal. Go ahead.
Oh, a criminal named Demon has struck the city and is murdering officials. Officials are...
A laser beam melts through the reporter's head and the screen goes black. It's party time!
Oh, God.
The demons. They are here.
you say.
But not for long.
This is our chance to get the story back on track.
Yeah.
You set alight a bus. As the sirens scream their heads off, you watch the flames engulf the bus and watch the destruction unfold before you. Suddenly, a military jet screams over your head. This was supposed to be a fantasy.
It's a modern day fantasy, I guess.
Maybe they're making like it's an urban fantasy. Maybe the demons were the military all along.
Oh, maybe. And the we thought we were hearing regular sirens, but it was the noise the demons made.
Yes. Take flight to combat the military aircraft. That's not a boy. That's an experimental government aircraft. You fire a bolt of energy and destroy the helicopter, okay, before turning to face the jet. There we go. You fire a beam of pure, concentrated fear into the pilot's eyes.
Oh my god.
Hell yeah.
I think that's worse than just a straight up laser beam.
That's like Ghost Rider.
Yeah.
There is a move in Pokemon, and I'm going to forget about it until the point where we see it again. But there's a move that's like, you whisper things into the enemy's ear, causing severe emotional damage. And I'm like,
oh god. Jeez.
Yes. Good.
Fear me.
Fear me.
Pilot falls out of the sky, screaming. The jet crashes into the ground, killing the pilot instantly. You are suddenly attacked from behind by the remaining military soldier. Well, it's not going to do much.
Oh, what if the remaining military soldier is James Jameson?
James Jameson? Is that you, mortal?
You ask. Curious.
See, we thought we were doing a separate story, but really, it's just the sequel.
It's like a far-flung sequel.
Yeah. They made it like 20 years later.
20 years later, yeah. They made it 20 years later with three directors and no plan, and then they got really upset.
Yeah.
Help, he screams. The plane's dropping lower. I'm gonna burn up if it doesn't crash soon. Fire a bolt of psychic energy, killing James.
Oh, no. Guess we had to wrap up his story sometime.
I guess so. Hmm.
Made you look.
You turn and face the city. Suddenly, a light flashes on in your head. You remember, the military dropped a nuclear bomb on the city.
Yeah! The military was the demons the whole time!
Oh! Fucking, that's some Resident Evil shit.
Called it. reflect on the crimes of humanity.
We're going deep in here.
You reflect on the crimes of humanity. It's just a city. It's just a building. It won't save you. It won't save humanity. What is there to be gained from the destruction of a city? Nothing.
Oh my god. That's deep.
Wake me up inside. You awaken in the bed of a truck, covered in dirt. You notice the sun is beginning to rise.
It was just a dream.
It was all a dream. Wake me up inside. Save me, you say, riding off into the sunset.
Wake me up inside. Save me, you say, riding off into the sunset. You spot a home. A man runs out, screaming and begging for you to spare him. You point your finger at him in fire. Suddenly, you find yourself in a small white room. Damn. This is just David Lynch now.
I think we popped back into the asylum. Institution.
It was a dream within a dream.
Yeah, we're getting all Inception.
Save me from the dark. You say to your insane self. Suddenly, your head begins to hurt. The walls pulse and the floors wobble. You fall to the ground as a single tear falls from your eye. Your phone rings. I guess they just let us have a phone.
I guess so. Hello? I don't know if that's us. Oh, I think that is us.
Hello? Are you the hospital? I just killed a man. Put a gun up to his head. Pulled the trigger, now he's dead.
Mama!
Mama! I just killed a man. I just killed a man. You hold your head and try to make sense of what just happened. Me too, buddy. The man you just killed, James, begins to scream from the floor. Help!
Uh-oh.
Someone help!
Turns out we weren't a demon, we were just on drugs.
Hell yes! He's killing everyone, the man screams. The walls begin to shake. I'll save you from the dark.
Oh, that's creepy.
I've come home. Bid my blood to run. To save you from the light.
No.
Good night, sweet prince.
Oh, this is so good.
Thank you for the music. Thank you for the joy. Thank you for the laughter. Thank you for the dreams. Thank you for the nightmares. Thank you for the dreams you've left me with. That is anime as hell!
Yeah, holy shit.
Thank you for the joy. Thank you for the laughter. Thank you for the dreams. Thank you for the nightmares. Thank you for the joy. Thank you for the dreams. Thank you for the nightmares. The end!
Hell yeah!
Oh, that's awesome. You wake up, staring at a painted Hollywood sign. It reads, "The End." You stare at the screen, uncomprehending. Suddenly, the text changes to, "You have won!"
We were in a video game the whole time.
Hell yeah.
Oh my god, we got two fantastic endings.
Victory fanfare, everybody. Not only did we do it, we did it twice.
Hell yeah.
I don't know about you, but I'm pretty happy with how that whole thing turned out.
Yeah, me too. I think that was the best session of AI Dungeon I've ever experienced.
I think so too. This will be our third and fourth complete session, I think. Never before have I seen the text read out, "You have won." So I think I'm just going to take it. I'm just going to take it as it comes.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. So let's recap here. Our first go-around was a cyberpunk adventure.
Yes.
And it turned out we were the robot the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
We were the ghost within the shell.
Yeah. Bob was not actually a robot. We just shot some poor man. And he tried to take us out with his poison sandwich. And it didn't work.
And then...
And...
We found out... Go ahead.
Yeah, we tried to go to City Hall and get ourselves some food, and we were set up, and then we transferred our consciousness like a badass into James Jameson, a soldier.
In a heroic last stand in which we killed three men before they could draw their guns, and then stole the fourth one.
Yeah. And then lived out the rest of our life as a police officer.
That's right. Before switching to our second campaign, where we started out as a man
and like hunting a demon that he was tracking through the woods until it totally just like wrecked us immediately.
Yeah. It wrecked us. We passed out, woke up in, I guess, a hospital. Did we wake up in a hospital?
We woke up in like one of the last vestiges of mankind. It was I was envisioning like a church or something, like it's the beginning of Bloodborne or something.
Yeah, I was getting culty vibes for sure.
And a little boy tried to solicit us and we killed him immediately.
And it unleashed the demon within ourselves.
Yes. It unleashed the demon within ourselves at the same time that the rest of the demons started to attack. And we became what we feared most. We stared into that abyss and we just destroyed everything for like a while.
Oh, we got some coffee. That was very nice.
Yeah, we met a barista. She seemed like pretty okay with it.
Yeah.
And then we killed her anyway.
Yeah, we accidentally killed her. And then it turned out that we weren't... Oh, no. We killed James.
We killed... we killed James, and then it was like a dream within a dream within a dream.
Yeah.
Within a dream.
Uh-huh.
And then we woke up. We woke up after our murderous spree in the back of a truck heading towards a beautiful sunset where a man ran out and said, "Oh my God, it's you. You're the one who tried to kill me." And then we woke up again in like a mental institution.
Uh-huh, with James next to us.
And then we just, I guess, started talking to like a demon in our head.
Ugh. Yeah, we had a whole kind of badass anime monologue.
It's,
I don't know how else to put it.
It's like, it's a mix between like an anime monologue and one of those notebooks from a serial killer where you get to like the last page and it's just like all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy.
Yeah, and it's just repeating over and over again.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, that's gonna call it for today, as far as AI Dungeon 2 goes. But thank you everybody in for either joining us here, joining us later, or somehow joining us in the past. Stick around next time, and we will see you again. Take it easy.
Goodbye, everybody.